Can a liquid change the way that a jar rolls down a ramp? Welcome to Corey's Curious Science, where we do science experiments that you can try in your kitchen or in your classroom. Today, I'll be rolling some jars down my homemade ramp, but I have half filled these jars with some liquids you might find around your kitchen. The first one, I filled it with water. The second one is golden syrup, and the third is glucose syrup. You might notice too that I've added a couple of rubber bands to each of these jars. I'm interested in investigating how they roll down the slope, and these rubber bands will give it some extra grip to make sure it doesn't slide instead. Let's try the water first. I would have thought that the water would take about 2 seconds to go down the ramp, but I'm going to time it to find out exactly how long it takes. Line up the water. 3, 2, 1. And it took about 1.5 seconds to go down the ramp, so that's slightly faster than I thought. But I wonder how long the golden syrup will take to go down the ramp. The golden syrup is quite a bit thicker than the water, but it weighs about the same, so I would have thought that maybe it would take about the same time to go down the ramp. But let's try it. Line it up. 3, 2, 1. Oh. Can you see that? Isn't that cool? Our jar is going really quite slowly. And it's almost down the bottom. There we go. That took about 27 seconds for it to go from the top of the ramp down to the bottom. I'll show you the glucose syrup at the end of the video. But if you want to try this at home, try changing a couple of different things. See what happens when you change the angle on your ramp. Or maybe you can find some different liquids that I haven't tried here. Or maybe you can try filling the jars up to different amounts. I filled mine all up halfway, but I wonder what would happen if you only filled it up a quarter of the way or all the way. Okay, so as promised, it's time for me to do the glucose syrup. Let's give it a go. Okay, the glucose syrup has oozed down to the bottom, so it's ready to test it. 3, 2, 1. Oh. That's going really slowly. So we're almost 30 seconds in now, and it hasn't even gone halfway down the ramp. Have a close look at what's happening to the syrup as the jar rolls down the ramp. And that's 1 minute past now, and we're almost down to the bottom. So close now. And that was 1 minute and 35 seconds that it took to go from the top of the ramp right down to the bottom. Now, as always, if you tried this experiment at home, I'd love to hear how it went for you. So let me know down in the comments. Also, remember to watch out for part two of this topic, where I explore the exciting science that's happening inside our jars. Happy sciencing!